So, in case an assert function would not be available in your language, you could easily roll out your own. I'm coming up with my own assert function, which I call my own assert, takes a condition. If the condition is false, then we raise an assertion error. Now, if I invoke, say, my own assert on 2 plus 2 equals 4, very simple test, we can run this and, well, nothing happens because the assertion is met. However, if we assume that 2 plus 2 equals 5, we can run this and we get an assertion or error that's being raised in here. And this gives us almost the same functionality as the built-in assertions. While you can easily roll out your own assertion, built-in assertions typically do have a couple of advantages. There's identification. A built-in assertion typically tells you which assertion failed. There's location. They tell you where the assertion failed, that is, where in the code. They're optional, meaning that they can be turned on or off, although turning assertions off is mostly a bad idea, which we will discuss later. And finally, they're standardized, meaning that everybody can immediately recognize an assertion as such because they always take the same form. In the languages C and C++, for instance, assertions come with a built-in function named assert, as in Python, which you get by including a special file, assert.h, and then, as in Python, you use assert, except that you put the argument in parentheses, and again, you pass the condition as an argument to the assert function. If this assertion failed, you're going to get a message on the console right before the program exits. And the message will look something like this. There you go. And now you can see that the message actually has everything we wanted in our built-in assertions. So first, the failing assertion is identified down here as coming directly from the code. You see the location. Here it's in the file foo.c in line 9. In C and C++, assertions are optional. You can turn them on and off using a simple argument to the compiler. And finally, they're standardized. If you include assert.h, that's always the form, and this is what programmers look for, and this is what programmers understand.